Hey, Mark Milan here. Thank you for letting me be a part of your day. And depending on whether you're watching this in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, maybe you're doing something and you're just listening to this. I felt it in my heart really to share some scriptures on worship that are so impactful for me as a believer and as a worship leader. So I hope this devotional really encourages you and really draws you closer to the Father's heart. I'm going to be taking a look at two areas of scripture that I think can bring some life into the idea of worship being so personal and important to God. So I'm looking at Ezekiel chapter 44, and I'll read it to you. I'm reading from the NASB version of the Bible. I'm just going to read a chunk of the scriptures and then talk about it a little bit and then flip over to another one that I think can give some more context, okay? So this is Ezekiel chapter 44, says this, starting in verse 8. That you have not kept charge of my holy things yourselves, but you set foreigners to keep charge of my sanctuary. Thus says the Lord God, no foreigner uncircumcised in heart and uncircumcised in the flesh of all the foreigners who among the sons of Israel shall enter my sanctuary. But the Levites who went far from me when Israel went astray, who went astray from me after idols, shall bear the punishment of their iniquity. Yet they shall be ministers in my sanctuary. That's real important. We'll come back to that. Yet they shall be ministers in my sanctuary, having oversight at the gates of the house and ministering in the house. They shall slaughter the burnt offerings and the sacrifice for the people, and they shall stand before them to minister to them. I have this underlined in my Bible. Because they ministered to them before their idols and became a stumbling block of iniquity to the house of Israel. Therefore, I have sworn against them, declares the Lord, that they shall bear the punishment for their iniquity. Verse 13, and they shall not come near to me to serve as priests to me, nor come near any of my holy things, to the things that are most holy, but they will bear the shame and their abominations which they have committed. Yet I will appoint to them charge of the house, of all its service, and of all that shall be done to it. Now, I'm going to read you a couple of more passages in this one chapter, but before I do, I'm going to switch to Deuteronomy chapter 10, because when God was establishing the priesthood, which came through the tribe of Levi, just to give you some context, there were 12 tribes, and Levi was the tribe that in the very, very beginning, when Moses went up on the mountain and the people of Israel were waiting for God to speak to them, all of God's people began to create and worship an idol, a golden calf. When Moses came down to confront them, it was the Levitical tribe, that bloodline, that felt the conviction, and they came out and they stood with Moses when Moses said, who will be for Yahweh? So God rewarded the tribe of Levi with the responsibility to minister to him in all of the things regarding worship and sanctuary as kind of like a message of grace, because the tribe of Levi were partying just like everybody else, right? But they made a decision to repent and kind of come with Moses. And when they stood beside Moses, God rewarded them with the responsibility of the priesthood in the things regarding worship and sanctuary. Now, the word minister simply means to serve. So when we hear that word, it's important for us to remember that minister or ministry means to serve. So I'm going to take you back to the passage of scripture back in Deuteronomy, where God kind of gives them their purpose statement for their ministry. So this is Deuteronomy chapter 10, and it says this, at the time the Lord set apart the tribe of Levi to carry the ark of the covenant of the Lord, to stand before the Lord, to serve him, and to bless his name until this day. I'll read you verse 9. That was verse 8. This is verse 9. Therefore, Levi does not have a portion or inheritance for his brothers. The Lord is their inheritance, just as the Lord your God spoke to them. There's another passage similar in Chronicles as well. So you can see that the Lord had given the tribe of Levi the responsibility of ministering to him. It was a personal thing. They were to minister to him, stand before him, be in his presence. And really everything they were to do for the people of Israel was for God, right? To God, for the benefit of people. But as we read these passages in Ezekiel, we see kind of a different focus that has happened. And the Lord is kind of upset about it, and he's telling the tribe of Levi, look, you've been ministering to the people. You've been standing before them. You've been ministering to them because they minister to them. That's what it says in verse 12. And so the Lord says this, because you've been letting the focus of your ministry be the people, and the people are the most important thing to you, I'm going to reward you with that. Your reward is that you get to serve people. You get to work in my house. That's what he says, basically. In verse 14, I'll reread it again. It says, yet I will appoint to them to keep charge of the house, of all its services, of all that shall be done. But in the verse right before, verse 13, it says, and they shall not come near to me to serve me as priests, nor come near to any of my holy things. So he goes, okay, so you've lost focus. I set you apart to serve me. I set you apart to worship me, and everything you did in service was to be focused on me. But your focus has shifted and it's become other things. You've chased idols. One of the important things about the priests, and one of their really greatest responsibilities, was that when the priests stopped seeking God and they stopped worshiping God, they ended up automatically teaching the people of Israel idolatry at the same time. So when they lost focus for what was the most important thing in their own personal worship, it affected everybody else in Israel. So let me read you verse 15 and 16, but the Levitical priests, the sons of Zadok, who kept charge of my sanctuary when the sons of Israel went astray. You see the result there. The people of Israel went astray because the priests went astray. The sons of Zadok, they shall come near to me and minister to me, and they shall stand before me to offer me the fat and the blood, declares the Lord the God. They shall enter my sanctuary. They shall come near to my table to minister to me and keep my charge. What a contrast, right? The other verses, he's saying, well, those priests, they're not ministering to me anymore. They're involved in pleasing people and doing all these things for people. And so they can go chase their idols. But the priests of Zadok, their eyes are on me. Their eyes are on my heart. So I want them to be able to come near to me. It's so important. And here's the point of this devotional today. And I hope you take time to look at both Ezekiel chapter 44 and read Deuteronomy chapter 10 in context. The reward of ministry, the reward of worship is God. We get to come near to him, and we get to minister to him, and we get to receive from him directly. That's the beauty and the wonder of worship, that God allows us to come near to him. And so in the process of serving the Lord in our position, whether it is worship or something else, it's so important that we remember that we do it to God for the benefit of people. And we can't flip that. It can't be to people, because the people don't give us what we need. Only God's heart can really lead us correctly to the needs of people. So we seek his heart, we worship him above all things. I hope this devotional encourages you today to kind of just seek his heart in the secret place and keep your eyes fixed on him, the author and perfecter of our faith. Until next time.